Good day, student. My name is Ambali Rasak Olabanji. I will be your physics teacher for today's lesson. Topic: Electrolysis. Objective: At the end of the lesson, learner should be able to analyze the concept of electrolysis with emphasis on 1. Electrolyte and non-electrolyte, 2. The dynamics of charged particle, ions, and ions in electrolyte, 3. The final product obtained from electrolysis depend on the electrolyte as well as the material of the electrode, 4. Faraday's first law, and finally, application of electrolysis. Electrolysis is a process by which electric current is passed through substance to effect a chemical change. The process is carried out in an electrolytic cell, an apparatus consisting of positive and negative electrodes held apart and deep into a solution containing positively and negatively charged ions. The chemical change is called electrolysis. The electrolyte and the electrode used in electrolysis form an electrolytic cell. When electricity passes through an electrolyte, the positive ions of the electrolyte move towards the cathode negative electrode, where they gain electron to become a neutral substance. The negatively charged electrode in electrolysis is called the cathode. Positively charged ion moves towards the cathode. The positively charged electrode in electrolysis is called the anode. Negatively charged ion moves towards the anode. The diagram below simply indicates the movement of ions inside the solution. The second diagram also shows the movement of ions towards the anode and the cathode. Electrolysis of acidulated water. Go through the diagram below. On the left side, you have platinum, the anode. This is the anode. Also on the right side, we also have platinum, which is also the cathode. The whole cycle is connected as shown on the diagram. The passage of electricity through water produces a chemical effect on the water by splitting it into oxygen and hydrogen, and these are collected in the anode and cathode respectively. The volume of hydrogen produced is twice that of oxygen. The acidulated water contains hydrogen ion H+ and hydroxy OH-. Produced from water, as well as hydrogen ion H+ and sulfate ion SO4-24, produced from the acid. As the current passes, hydrogen ion moves towards the cathode, where they gain electrons to become hydrogen atom, which now combine in pair to become hydrogen molecules. These are illustrated as follows. Stage 1. Hydrogen ion plus electron gives hydrogen atom. Second stage. Hydrogen atom plus hydrogen atom gives hydrogen molecule. The current flow also makes the hydrogen ion and sulfate ion to move towards the anode, where the hydrogen ion only loses the electron, and as a result, oxygen is liberated. The sulfate ion stays in the solution. These are illustrated as follows. Stage 1. OH- minus electron gives us OH, that is. The second stage also gives us OH plus OH, will give us water plus oxygen atom. The third stage, oxygen atom plus oxygen atom, will give us oxygen molecule. We'll be going on break. After the break, we will continue. Thank you. Welcome back. Electrolysis of copper sulfate solution with copper electrode. Connect a copper voltmeter consisting of a beaker of copper sulfate solution and two clean copper electrodes as shown in the diagram below. Inside the diagram, you have a voltmeter containing copper surface solution with two electrodes. Both of them are copper, one for anode, one for cathode. All they are connected to a battery, an ammeter, and a rheostat to maintain steady current in series. The passage of electric current through the electrolyte for a period of time results in copper being deposited on the cathode. The anode is also observed to have lost an equal amount of copper. The passage of current, however, does not affect the density of the copper sulfate solution. Copper sulfate solution contains copper ions as well as hydrogen ion. And also hydroxyion from water. During the passage of current, both copper and hydrogen ion move towards the cathode. However, only copper ion are discharged at the cathode, while the hydrogen ion remain in the electrolyte. The copper ion gains electron to become neutral copper atom. The passage of current also makes the hydroxy and the sulfate ion to move towards the positive anode. However, at the anode, the copper atom of the anode go into the solution as copper ion, and this process takes place more easily than the discharge of hydroxy and sulfate ion. The hydroxy and sulfate ion thus remain inside the solution. As the current continues to move through the electrolyte, the anode continues to decrease in thickness, while the thickness of the cathode continues to increase. Faraday's first law of electrolysis. The law states that the mass of any element deposited during electrolysis is proportional to the quantity of electricity passing through an electrolyte. Quantity of electricity Q is given by Q is equal to IT, where I, current in ampere, and T, time in seconds. The first law could therefore be restated as the mass of an element deposited during electrolysis is proportional to the current and to the time for which the current flows. Therefore, M is directly proportional to IT, where M is equal to ZIT, where Z is equal to a constant called electrochemical equivalent, ECE. The first law could be verified in the laboratory by plotting a graph of mass of substance deposited M against quantity of electricity Q. The graph should be a straight line passing through the origin. Electrochemical equivalent. The electrochemical equivalent ECE of a substance is defined as the substance deposited when 1 ampere of current flows for 1 second. Since 1 coulomb is equal to 1 ampere times 1 second, the mass per coulomb of a substance deposited during electrolysis is therefore the ECE of the substance. It thus follows that a current of 2 ampere flowing for 10 seconds will deposit a mass of substance M given by M is equal to ZIT, where Z is equal to ECE of the substance. This is equal to 2, where this is equal to Z times 2 times 10, which will give us 20 Z gram. The ECE of a substance is expressed in gram per coulomb. We'll be going on break. After the break, we'll come back and solve class work example. Thank you. Come back to the class again. Class work example. Electrochemical equivalent of silver is 0.001118 gram per coulomb. What does this statement mean? Determine the mass of silver deposited in 1.5 minutes when a current of 2 ampere is passed through a silver solution. Solution. A. The ECE of copper is 0.001118 gram per coulomb, means that a current of 1 ampere flows through a silver solution for 1 second. It deposits 0.00118 gram of silver. B. 1 coulomb deposits 0.001118 gram of silver, that is 1.5 times 2 times 60. C. We deposit 0.00118 times 1.5 times 2 times 60, which will give us 0.20124 gram. Example 2. In electrolysis of copper sulfate, copper is deposited evenly on a cathode of area 50 cm square when a current of 3 ampere is passed for 25 minutes. Determine the thickness of the layer of copper deposited. Bracket open, EC of copper 0.0033 gram per coulomb, density of copper 9 gram per centimeter square, per centimeter cube rather. Solution. Mass of copper deposited is equal to ZIT, where Z is equal to ECE of copper and I current and T time in second. Mass of copper will be 0.0033 times 3 times 25 times 60, which give us 1.485 gram. Volume of copper is equal to mass over density, which is 1.485 divided by 9, which give us 0.165 centimeter cube. Therefore, thickness of copper will be volume over area, that is 0.165 divided by 50. Will give us a thickness of 0.0033 centimeter. Example 3. 18 meter plate, 8 centimeter by 5 centimeter, is to have a layer of copper 0.15 millimeter thick deposited on both sides. If a current of 0.8 ampere is to be used, how long will this take? Bracket open, EC of copper as given and density also as given above. Solution. Area of one side of the metal is equal to 8 times 5 centimeter square. This is equal to 40 centimeter square. Volume of copper deposited will give us area times thickness. This is equal to 40 times 0.15, which will give us 0.6 centimeter cube. Mass of copper, density times volume, will give us 9 times 0.6. Via the mass of copper deposited, will give us 5.4 gram. But mass of copper deposited is equal to ZIT. Therefore, T is equal to mass over IT, which will give us 5.4 over 0.8 times 0.0033. And this will give us 20454.5 seconds. However, this is the time it will take to deposit copper on one side of the plate. Hence, to deposit copper on both sides of the metal, we take 2 times 20454.5, and that will give us 40901 seconds. Application of electrolysis. 1. Electroplating. Electroplating is a process by which base metal are coated with layer of more expensive metal, that is, e.g., silver, chromium, gold, cadmium. Electroplating protects the base metal against atmospheric corrosion as well as give them a more attractive appearance. 2. Refining of copper. The copper that deposit on the cathode during electrolysis involving copper is very pure. Any impurity in the copper anode are left in the solution. Pure copper obtained in this way is called electrolytic copper. Such a copper is very useful in the manufacture of electric cable since it has a very low electric resistance because of its high purity. 3. Manufacture of aluminium and sodium. The electrolysis of common salt and aluminium oxide result in the manufacture of sodium and aluminium respectively. These metals are liberated at the cathode during electrolysis. Thank you very much.